Good day to everyone. Today let's see how to way switches and intermediate switches work, and also how to wire it correctly onto a circuit. This is a two-way switch. But you can't just decide it by seeing only the front view of the switch, since it has the same front view as a one-gang switch. When you look at the rear side of it, there are three terminals, top one marked as common, and the other two marked as L1 and L2. Let's keep the front view of this switch also on a side. If you press the switch upwards, common terminal connects with L1 terminal. When you change the switch position to downwards, common terminal breaks its contact with L1 and connects with L2. These switches do not have an off position, as in a single gang switch. Changing the switch to upward or downward position would make common terminal to change its connection with L1 and L2 accordingly. If you connect power supply to common terminal, position 2 or downward position of the switch will make current to flow through common port to L2. Likewise, if you change the position of the switch to 1, flow of current will be through common port to L1. These switches can also be called as SPDT or single pole double throw switches, since the single pole common port is throwing power to two ports, namely to L1 and L2. Now, let's see how an intermediate switch works. Like the two-way switch, intermediate switch 2 cannot be identified from its front view. On the rear side, you will see two L1 terminals on top and two L2 terminals at the bottom. Let's keep the front view of the switch also on a side. Here the switch is at upward position, and we will mark it as position 1. Now you will see, the first L1 terminal connects to the L2 terminal directly under it. Second L1 terminal also connects like that, and is to the L2 terminal directly under it. Now let's change the switch position to position 2, or downwards. Here you see, two L1 terminals break its connection they previously had with L2, and reconnects with its opposite side L2 terminals. If you connect two power lines to two L1 terminals now, current flow path will be changed to its opposite direction L2 terminals. Change the switch position to 1 now, and the current flow will be through the L2 terminals directly under the L1 terminals. These are DPDT or double pole double throw type switches, where two inlet poles are capable of throwing power to two separate outlet ports. Let's see how to wire a circuit with two-way switches. These are normally used on staircases and corridors to operate a light or a set of lights from two or more locations. If the switch 1 is at the bottom of a staircase, switch 2 can be placed to operate a light after climbing the steps to next floor level. First, you need to connect two L1 terminals together. Then, two L2 terminals also connected together. Phase wire can be connected to common terminal of one of the two switches. Common terminal of the other switch need to be connected to the bulb. Neutral line 2 needs to be connected to the bulb. Now the wiring of the circuit is completed. Let's show the front views of the two switches also on the picture like this. If both switches are at its position 1, both common terminals are connected with its L1 terminals. Since the electrical circuit is completed now, bulb is lighted up. If someone at the switch number 1, or at the bottom of the staircase need to switch off the light now, he need to change the switch position to number 2. Then the common port of switch number 1 changes its connection with L1 to L2 and breaks the circuit, making the bulb to switch off. Also, if anyone at the upper floor needs this light to go down the stairs now, he or she needs to change the present position of the switch number 2 to position 2, making the bulb to light up again. Let's see how an intermediate switch is wired on a circuit like this. Intermediate switches are required when there are long corridors or staircases running more than two stories. Other than these two-way switches, at the start and end positions of a corridor, you need one or more intermediate switches in the middle to operate the same light or set of lights. Here, The phase and neutral wires connected to the bulb through the two common ports of the two-way switches will not be changed. Hence, I have kept those wires intact. Previously, when wiring the two-way switches, we connected the two L1 terminals together. Here also we do the same, but on the way it goes through one set of L1 and L2 terminals on the intermediate switch. Then we need to connect two L2 terminals on the two-way switches together, that too is through the remaining set of L1 and L2 terminals on the intermediate switch. Now the wiring is completed. Let's show the front views of the three switches, also on the picture. All three switches are at upward position or at position 1. Green lines show how the terminals of the switches are connected internally. Bulb is lighted up now, since the electrical circuit is completed. Here it shows how the current flows through the completed path to light up the bulb. If someone in a room at the start of a corridor changes the switch number 1 position downwards, light will be switched off. Then, if someone in a room at the middle of the corridor needs to go out at night, he needs to change the position of the nearest intermediate switch to downward position. It will change the internal arrangement of the intermediated switch, making the circuit to be completed again, and light up the bulb. Here it shows the completed path of the electrical circuit to light up the bulb. Let's assume someone who got out of the room will walk to the end of the corridor and needs to switch off the light on the corridor before he leaves out. Only what he needs to do is change the present position of the switch to position 2 or downwards, and break the circuit from there to switch off the light. Likewise, you can introduce more intermediate switches to the circuit, just keeping two-way switches at the start and end positions. Hope you got fair idea now how to wire two-way switches and intermediate switches, and how the terminals of these switches are connected internally. If the video is helpful to you, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.